Here at Outlaws, Coach Dion Randy, I gotta ask you guys. Tyson Fury just got fined last month £3,000, like $6,000, for talking smack on Twitter.
It was deserved.
Why?
Deserved. I mean, I don't know, man. After David Price lost, he really is up to smack talking. Like he's.
But that's boxing.
But that's boxing, and that's how you sell a fight. You know what I mean? So
true, but like,
look, that's his product, and his talking shit is what's selling his product. So him putting, you know.
I think the commission need to fine themselves for fining him for unsportsmanlike conduct. How are you gonna fine an athlete for marketing himself?
And the other thing, is selling a fight. You know what I mean? Because outside
what
of that.
What is he selling, though? He's not scheduled to fight any big names. He's fighting some dude.
No, Steve Cunningham. He's a very good fighter.
When he does, When
Cunningham,
he does,
like Cunningham, huh?
And when he does, even with that, he incites other fighters to want to fight him because they want to shut him up, and it incites people to want to watch because.
That's why England is not America. I respect a lot of British fighters like Amir Khan, Carl Froch, some of my favorite fighters, but. For the commission over there, imagine James Toney would be owing money by now.
Oh, yeah.
Floyd Mayweather, even Brandon Rios, Adrian Broner, all these guys that are very popular because of their personality.
Yeah. I mean, but you also gotta look too, especially the thing that went down with Chisora and David Haye and stuff. Maybe they're trying to, you know, cool something down. You know, maybe there's something going over there that we don't know about, which they're trying to keep from escalating and getting out of hand. So.
What do you think about this, Brandon? In England, Tyson Fury fined £3,000 for talking smack on Twitter.
Oh, that's really?
That's weak, huh?
I don't got freedom of speech out there?
I guess not. I guess the Queen will execute you if you do it.
Yeah, no, that's surprising.
He was talking smack about David Price.
But it's Twitter, you know what I mean? So that's like his own personal, dude, whatever. You know what I mean? And again, it's selling the fight.
You think they're just hating on him because he's outgoing?
How are you, man?
I don't know. I'm good. I agree with Randy. I think what it is after David Haye and Chisora, that whole thing, that they want to calm that before it gets out of hand, if it, you know, has the potential to get out of hand. So, you know, I'm like, whatever. But, dude, that kind of stuff, again, that sells fights. That's part of boxing. That's part of boxing is, you know, fighter talking mess. That's what makes it entertaining. You know, because
that's what sells.
Yeah, that's what sells. That's what made Ali was just all of his smack. You know, and the thing is if a guy can back it up, I'm not saying Tyson Fury can, but if a guy can back it up, that makes it that much more exciting of a fighter.
So, what would you tell the people in England about finding him?
Tell them to get a life, man. Don't find somebody for that. Let them do their thing. If it's to the point where you know it's about to turn violent outside of the ring, then. Yeah, you want to step in and avoid that, but if it's just part of the game, let it happen.
So if a fighter loses and you're in England, do not say anything about the guy who lost or you will be fined.
That's just stupid.